Now, here's in fact an observation that I think everyone in the room sees daily. Anhedonia. So anhedonia is the absence of pleasure. We often say that 75% of people with depression report anhedonia. And anhedonia is not just prevalent, but it is persistent, and it has been identified as a detractor, no surprise, to quality of life and function. So far, we all know that. What this is telling us is if you look at two large databases, these are two large studies that evaluated antidepressant treatment. And what they discovered was is that the greater the intensity of anhedonia, which was proxied by an item on a depression rating scale, the worse the SSRI works. In other words, the more anhedonic your patient is, the less likely an SSRI will help your patient. That's a problem. That is a big time problem in the sense that this is the core of depression. And this is a core feature of depression that's mediating the quality of life reduction as well as the ability for people to engage. Now, does this apply to every antidepressant? No. More recent data shows that vortioxetine Trintellix can actually very significantly improve anhedonia. Ketamine treatment, we'll speak about that shortly, has also been shown to significantly improve anhedonia. There's a story that's unfolding that this disturbance in anhedonia may in fact be amenable to engaging opioid systems. What about anti-inflammatory approaches? We'll say more about that a bit later on. But for me, when I see someone with depression, I prescribe the antidepressant, and if they don't have emotional blunting from that SSRI, they certainly have anhedonia, and the anhedonia just persists. And they say, I don't feel much better, I see my kids, I just can't be bothered, I don't have any motivation, I have no joy, I just feel just not myself. And that is, in fact, anhedonia.